as I go to bed. Mum wants to spend the next few weeks alone. She pooh-poohed any attempts we made to arrange visits. Magnus had booked holiday to be with her until she'd completed her next round of chemotherapy. But she pushed back to the point of being almost aggressive about it. There are limits to what we can decide on her behalf, Magnus said when we spoke about it afterwards. I mean, she's a grown woman. She's old, I replied. Middle-aged, Magnus replied. And still 100% compos mentis, he added. After discovering Mum sleeping in Dad's old cabin on Christmas Eve in a temperature of -7 degrees, I had my doubts about the last part. Her actions suggested terrible judgment, even for her. But she seemed to improve over Christmas, both in terms of her form and her mood. And when we left this morning, she appeared almost well. Better than she seemed in years, I remarked to Aslak as we turned off the driveway and saw her standing and waving exaggeratedly at Viljar. Aslak said nothing. He's been hinting at moving back to the village lately. Just the odd comment here and there, sneaked into conversation with Mum and Magnus and Viljar. Imagine how nice it is to live somewhere that gets snow all winter long, Viljar. And with craft and cunning, he used Mum's illness as a means to strengthen his argument. Mia is moving out in the autumn either way, I heard him tell Mum one evening when Mia and I were sitting in the living room watching a film, while Mum and Aslak sat together in the kitchen. Very true, Mum chirped. I'm still suppressing any thoughts of Mia moving out, or postponing them at any rate, until it's definite. Until she's been accepted into her university of choice. I'm moving out in the autumn either way, Mum, she's told me. I'm proud of her sense of independence, but still feel terrified that she'll leave me. We haven't spent more than a few weeks apart in our whole lives. When she left for a 4-week trip to Asia last summer, I curled up next to Viljar in his bed for the first 3 nights.